ओके, गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. वी आर डिस्कसिंग द चैप्टर लाइफ प्रोसेसेस. इन द लाइफ प्रोसेसेस आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू न्यूट्रिशन इन अमीबा एंड इन द पैरामीशियम. दीज आर यूनिसेलर, दे आर माइक्रोस्कोपिक, बट द स्टेप ऑफ द डाइजेशन दे आर द सेम. लाइक फर्स्ट देर इज इंजेशन, देन डाइजेशन, देन एब्जॉर्प्शन, देन एसिमिलेशन, and finally the ejection. So today I'll start that nutrition in complex multicellular animals like humans. We are complex multicellular animal. We are, in our case, like in grasshopper, fish, frog, all the process involving in nutrition are performed by a combination of digestive organs, because we are not unicellular. यूनिसेलर में भी सब कुछ होता है, बट वी आर हैविंग ऑर्गन सिस्टम लेवल ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ डाइजेस्टिव ऑर्गन इज कॉल्ड डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम. जो डाइजेस्टिव ऑर्गन का जो कॉम्बिनेशन है उसको हम बोलते हैं डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम. टूडे आई विल डिस्कस ऑल द प्रोसेस इन द न्यूट्रिशन ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स मल्टी सेलर एनिमल्स बाई टेकिंग एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इन ह्यूमन बींग. एंड यू नो दैट वी आर हैविंग ए लॉन्ग ट्यूब running from mouth to anus of human being, in which digestion and absorption of food take place, that is called alimentary canal. Alimentary canal is also called the gut. Now we'll study what is the digestion and absorption. So human digestive system, you can see that the nutrition in human beings, it takes place through human digestive system. The human digestive system consists of a alimentary canal and its associated glands. The various organs of the human digestive system starts from the mouth, then esophagus, we call the food pipe, then stomach, small intestine, large intestine. You can see the nutrition is a getting and utilization of energy rich nutrients, that is food, by an organism. Food provides energy for life activities, materials for growth, maintenance of body temperature, and repair of tissues. These are the main things. Apart from, there are many other things. So food can be, I told you that carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamins, minerals, water. The water plays an important role in metabolic processes and prevents dehydration of the body. The water is very important. We cannot survive without water. You know that. So digestive system, if you see, it is also called alimentary canal, is also called the gut. It starts from the mouth, then buccal cavity, then pharynx, then esophagus, then stomach, then small intestine, large intestine, then finally anus for ejection. The associated glands of digestive systems are salivary glands, gastric glands, liver, pancreas, interstitial glands. The human alimentary canal, which runs from mouth to anus, is about 9 meters long tube, and the ducts of various glands open into the alimentary canal and pour the secretion of these digestive juices into the alimentary canal. So I'll describe one by one. So you can see the mouth and buccal cavity. The human being have a special organ for the ingestion of food. It is called mouth. In human being, food is ingested through the mouth. So the food is put into the mouth with the help of hands. Mouth is to receive the food, that is ingestion. Buccal cavity or oral cavity or mouth cavity is same, that is consist of palate. The roof is called, roof of the cavity is called palate. Teeth and muscular tongue. There are three things. Palate has anterior hard plate, palate, and posterior soft palate. Tongue is a muscular organ attached to the floor of the oral cavity by the frenulum. Tongue has small projection called papillae. Some papillae bear the taste buds, and not at the back on either side of tongue there are tonsils. Okay. So the nature and the mode of arrangement of teeth is called dentition. I think this is not, dentition is not in our course, but I'll tell you a little bit. Like we are heterodont because we are having different kind of teeth. Thecodont, we are having the theca, and we are diphodont, that teeth comes two times in humans. The nature and mode of arrangement of teeth is called dentition. So this is our having four different kind of teeth: incisor, canine, premolar, and molar. The function of incisor is for cutting, canine for tearing, premolar is for mastication, molar is also for mastication. Premolar and molar are collectively called cheek teeth, which are having the cups. Now this is the arrangement of teeth. 2, 1, 3, 4 is our like diphodont. It means that teeth appear twice in lifetime. They are milky teeth and permanent teeth. The dental formula is like we are having 32, and the babies are having 20 teeth. So 2, 1, 2, 3 is our dental formula. Next is the pharynx. Common passage for digestive and respiratory system. The pharynx is common passage for digestive and respiratory system. That's why you can take also take you know, air through also mouth. So when food material passes through the pharynx, the cartilaginous epiglottis closes the glottis, that is opening of larynx, and prevents the entry of food into the trachea. So mouth is a common, like it will one, it goes into the esophagus, other is goes into the larynx. So when food material pass through the pharynx, the cartilaginous epiglottis closes the glottis. Just like a जैसे एक बॉटल को हम ऊपर से क्लोज कर देते हैं, ऐसे एपिग्लॉटिस ग्लॉटिस को बंद कर देता है. ठीक है, जैसे यहां आप देखें, आफ्टर दैट देयर इज अ ईसोफेगस. ईसोफेगस इज अ मस्कुलर ट्यूब अराउंड 30 सेंटीमीटर लॉन्ग दैट कंडक्ट फूड इनटू द स्टमक, दैट इज द ईसोफेगस. ओके, एंड posterior part of the esophagus has a gastroesophageal sphincter, that is a circular muscle. It controls the opening of esophagus into the stomach. So you can see that bowel, that food comes into the esophagus, and there is a circular muscles. They are contrasting the peristaltic movement, and due to this, the food which is already chewed by the teeth or with the help of saliva in the bolus form, because the teeth cut the food into small pieces, they chew and grind, and the teeth, they are helping in the physical digestion, and the salivary gland in our mouth, they are producing saliva, and tongue is helping the saliva with the food, they are mixing. Saliva is nothing but it is a watery fluid, and it wets the food in our mouth, and the wetted food can be swallowed more easily. So you know that the salivary glands, they are helping chemical digestion by secreting enzymes, and the human saliva contain an enzyme, it is called salivary amylase, which digests the starch that present in food into sugar. Thus the digestion of starch begins in the mouth itself. जो कार्बोहाइड्रेट का जो डाइजेशन है, इट विल स्टार्ट एट द माउथ, और प्रोटीन का जो डाइजेशन स्टार्ट होता है, दैट इज फ्रॉम द स्टमक. द डाइजेशन ऑफ स्टार्च बिगिंस इन द माउथ, एंड द फूड रिमेन्स इन द माउथ ओनली फॉर अ शॉर्ट टाइम, एंड द डाइजेशन ऑफ फूड रिमेन्स इन कंप्लीट इन माउथ. अब फूड माउथ से कहाँ पे गया? इसोफेगस के थ्रू स्टमक में. द स्लाइटली डाइजेस्टेड फूड इन द माउथ इज स्वेलोड बाय द टंग and goes down the food pipe. The other name of food pipe is called esophagus. You can see the structure of esophagus. It carries food to the stomach. It's a tube-like structure. it happens as follows, that wall of the food pipe have muscles which can contract and expand ventilatory. When the slightly digested food enters the food pipe, the wall of the food pipe start contraction and expansion movement, and the contraction and expansion movement of the wall of food pipe is called peristaltic movement. This is a peristaltic movement, and due to this movement, that food pipe pushes the slightly digested food into the stomach. Okay. And the stomach, the next is stomach. You can see the stomach, it's a J-shaped organ, J-shaped structure for storage and digestion. The function of stomach is storage as well as digestion of food. The food is churned into the stomach for about 3 hours. During this time, the food breaks down into smaller pieces and forms a semi-solid paste. The stomach wall contains 3 tubular glands in its wall. The glands present in the wall of the stomach secrete gastric juice. They are the 3 parts of the stomach. Upper is fundus, middle is cardiac, and lower is pyloric. And this pyloric stomach leads to the small intestine by an opening called pylorus, that is guarded by pyloral sphincter. The inner wall of the stomach bears a longitudinal fold. This is called rugi. And they are also having the tubular glands, 3 tubular glands, and they secrete the gastric juice. The gastric juice contains 3 substances. One is HCl, the other enzyme is pepsin, and the mucus. Due to the presence of in the stomach, due to the presence of hydrochloric acid, the gastric juice is acidic in nature, and the acidic medium, the enzyme pepsin, begins the digestion of proteins present in the food to form smaller molecules. क्योंकि जो पेप्सिन है वो काम करता है एसिडिक कंडीशन में, ठीक है? पेप्सिन कट करता है प्रोटीन्स को स्मॉलर मॉलिक्यूल्स में, लाइक स्मॉल पॉलीपेप्टाइड्स. दस द प्रोटीन डाइजेशन बिगन इन द स्टमक. कार्बोहाइड्रेट का डाइजेशन स्टार्ट हुआ माउथ में, और प्रोटीन का डाइजेशन स्टार्ट हुआ स्टमक में. तो प्रोटीन डाइजेस्टिव एंजाइम पेपेन इज एक्टिव ओनली इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ एन एसिड. इट विल नॉट एक्टिव इन द एल्कलाइन मीडियम. So that is the function of hydrochloric acid in the stomach, to make the medium of gastric juice acidic so that the enzyme pepsin can digest the protein properly. The another function of HCl is to kill any bacteria or any other organism which may enter the stomach with food. And the third thing is the mucus. Mucus helps to protect the stomach wall from its own secretion of hydrochloric acid. क्योंकि हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड आपके स्टमक को ही नुकसान ना पहुंचाए, उसके लिए एक थर्ड चीज होती है म्यूकस, और वो म्यूकस हेल्प करता है स्टमक वॉल को, ताकि वहां पे एचसीएल का फंक्शन, एचसीएल वहां पे जाके एचसीएल ज्यादा नुकसान ना पहुंचाए. तो इफ म्यूकस इज नॉट सिक्रेटेड, एचसीएल विल कॉज द इरोजन ऑफ इनर लाइनिंग ऑफ स्टमक, लीडिंग टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अल्सर इन द स्टमक. नाउ द पार्शियली डाइजेस्टेड फूड then goes from stomach to the small intestine. That is, the exit of food from stomach is guarded by sphincter muscle, which releases into the small amount into the small intestine. Now from stomach it will enter into the small intestine. You can see how it looks. So that the small intestine is the largest part of the alimentary canal. देखो कहने को बेटा ये small है, इसका diameter छोटा, इसलिए इसे स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन बोलते हैं, बट इट इज द लार्जेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ द एलिमेंट्री कैनाल. इट इज अबाउट 6.5 मीटर्स और 7 मीटर्स लॉन्ग इन एन अडल्ट मैन. एंड ऑल्दो द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन इज लॉन्ग, बट व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन, बिकॉज इट इज नैरो. जो इसका डायमीटर है वो इसका छोटा है, स्मॉल है, दैट्स व्हाई वी कॉल इट स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन. और जो लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन होती है उसका लेंथ कम होती है, बट उसका डायमीटर ज्यादा होता है. एज यू कैन सी द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन इज अरेंज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ए कॉइल इन आवर बेली. द लेंथ ऑफ ए स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन डिफर इन वेरियस एनिमल depending on the type of food they eat. For example, herbivorous animal like cow, which eat grass, need a longer small intestine to allow the cellulose present in grass to digest completely. And on the other hand, like meat is a food which is easier to digest, like in the carnivorous, they are like animals like tigers, which eat meat, have a shorter small intestine. So herbivorous mein iski length zyada hoti hai aur carnivorous mein inki length kam hoti hai. The small intestine in human beings is a site of complete digestion of food. It says site of complete digestion. Yahan pe complete digestion hota hai. Dekho, stomach mein bhi complete nahi hota. Stomach mein bhi partially hota hai. Complete digestion aapka ho jata hai small intestine mein. It is having three parts, duodenum, it is C-shaped, jejunum and ileum. Duodenum is C-shaped, jejunum is middle part and ileum is the terminal part of the small intestine. It's a site of complete digestion of food, carbohydrate, protein or fat. ये यहाँ पे completely digest हो जाते हैं. अब small intestine में आप देखो, the small intestine receives the secretion of two glands. यहाँ पे दो glands का secretion होता है, liver और pancreas. They are finger like villi also present in the mucosa. The liver secretes bile, and bile is not an enzyme. Bile is a greenish yellow liquid made in the liver and which is normally stored in gallbladder. Which is stored in gallbladder, and bile is a alkaline and contains salts which helps to emulsify or breaks the fats present in the food. Thus bile perform two functions. One is make the acidic food coming from stomach alkaline so that the pancreatic enzyme can work on it. Second, bile salt break the fat present in the food into small globules, making it easy to the for the enzyme to act on and digest them. This is the function of bile. Second, pancreas. The pancreas is a large gland which lies parallel to the beneath the stomach. Pancreas secrete pancreatic juice in which like they are having digestive enzyme like pancreatic amylase, trypsin, lipase, and the enzyme amylase that breaks the starch, enzyme trypsin digests the protein, and the enzyme lipase breaks down the emulsified fats. Now the wall of the small intestine, you can see they are also secreting intestinal juices. These are having number of enzymes which complete the digestion of complex carbohydrate into glucose. Because small intestine mein hi aapka digestion complete hota hai, so carbohydrates yahan convert ho jate hain glucose mein, proteins convert ho jate hain amino acid mein, aur fatty acid convert ho jate hain, fats convert ho jate hain fatty acid aur glycerol mein. So glycerol, glucose, amino acid, fatty acid and glycerol, they are small water soluble molecules. In this way the process of digestion converts a large and insoluble food molecule into small water soluble molecules. So the chemical digestion of food is brought about by the biological catalyst, they are called enzymes. Aur jo fats ki absorption hai, fats ki absorption kaise hoti hai? Absorption yahi pe hoti hai after digestion. I'll tell you ki how that absorption will take place. Abhi sirf after digestion the molecules of food become so small that they can pass through the wall of a small intestine with blood capillaries because it is highly vascularized. ठीक है, the wall is highly vascular. They are having lot of blood capillaries and this is called absorption. And it is due to there is a finger like villi also present there that increase the surface area. The small intestine is the main region for the absorption of digested food. In fact, the small intestine is specially adapted for absorbing the digested food. The inner surface of the small intestine has millions of tiny finger-like projection. They are called villi. And the presence of villi gives the inner wall of the small intestine a very large surface area. And due to this large surface area of small intestine, that helps in the rapid absorption of digested food. And the digested food, which is absorbed through the walls of the small intestine, goes into the blood. Now, the large intestine, it is having three: cecum, colon, rectum. It is 1.5 long meter long. You can see it is well developed in herbivores, but well small in man. Arising from the cecum is a finger-like vestigial organ. It is called vermiform appendix. Basically, it is for the digestion of cellulose. Now we are not taking cellulose, so that's why this organ is not it is not present. It is rudimentary, like vestigial. Colon consists of ascending colon, transverse colon, and descending colon. You can see the structure: the ascending, then transverse, then descending. After that, finally the rectum. Rectum is the last part of the large intestine. That pelvic colon leads to the rectum, that opens out by the anus. And anus is guarded by anal sphincter, that is circular voluntary muscles. Now, how the food digested in some herbivores, the large intestine consists of cellulose digesting bacteria, because we don't have taking the cellulose, we cannot digest the cellulose. That's why this is not developed in our case. So if you see the transverse section of human gut, you can see that the innermost layer is called mucosa, then submucosa, then muscularis, and outermost fibrous layer is called serosa. The mucosa is the innermost moist epithelial layer, contains secretory and absorptive cell. Okay, that is because हमारा जो maximum absorption जो होता है, that is in the small intestine or large intestine. And the main role of the villi, because they are increasing the surface area. सबसे ज्यादा आपका absorption होता है small intestine. So if you see at a glance how it is like, that schematic view, like you have taken food through mouth, salivary glands are there, then esophagus, then stomach, then in the small intestine, the liver and pancreas, they are the glands. They secrete the juices into the small intestine. The liver secretes, they are temporarily stored in the gallbladder, and then finally small intestine, then large intestine, then rectum, and then finally anus. The food is finally, the remaining part of the food which will not require, it get discarded from the body. That is called digestion. So what is the meaning of assimilation? Because absorption is here. Okay, so what is the meaning of assimilation? Assimilation means the blood carries the digested and dissolved food to all parts of the body, where it becomes assimilated as part of the cells. अब वो ब्लड से बाकी और सेल्स के पास गया, डिफरेंट ऑर्गन्स में गया, वहां पे उसने उसे एब्जॉर्ब कर लिया, क्योंकि ये सारा कुछ हो रहा है डिफ्यूजन करके. द एसिमिलेटेड फूड इज यूज बाय द बॉडी सेल्स फॉर ऑब्टेनिंग एनर्जी एज वेल एज फॉर ग्रोथ एंड रिपेयर. द एनर्जी इज रिलीज बाय द ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ एसिमिलेशन फूड इन द सेल्स ड्यूरिंग रेस्पिरेशन. अब इसी फूड का जो ग्लूकोज था अमाइनो एसिड से, इसी का रेस्पिरेशन होगा तो एनर्जी मिलेगी. So the digested food which is not used by the body immediately is stored in the liver in the form of carbohydrate called glycogen. The stored glycogen can be used as a source of energy by the body as and when required. So I'll tell you a little bit about the digestive gland. They secrete digestive juice like the salivary gland, gastric glands, liver, pancreas, and intestinal glands. You can see the salivary glands. There are three pairs: parotid, submaxillary, or sublingual. It's the largest salivary gland seen in chicks that parotid, there are two. The submaxillary is two seen in lower jaw, and the sublinguals, they are the below the tongue. The salivary gland secretes saliva. It contains 99.5% water, mucus, enzymes like salivary amylase that breaks the carbohydrate, and that's why the digestion of carbohydrate starts in the mouth. Then this our digestive gland, tubular glands that is found in the inner wall of the stomach. They secrete acid like gastric juices. Gastric consists three kind of cells: mucosa, neck cells, chief cells, and oxyntic cells. Mucus cells, they secrete mucus. Mucus and bicarbonate protect the stomach wall and from HCl and prevent autodigestion. Autodigestion means कि अगर हम कहें कि आपकी खुद की जो एंजाइम्स हैं वो आपके स्टमक को क्यों नहीं डाइजेस्ट कर देते. सपोज यू आर हंग्री एंड वाई नॉट योर और एंजाइम्स दे डाइजेस्ट द स्टमक. सो दैट्स व्हाई बिकॉज दीज एंजाइम्स आर इनएक्टिवेटेड एंड द सिक्रीशन दैट प्रिवेंट्स द ऑटो डाइजेशन. द चीफ सेल्स दे सीक्रेट प्रो एंजाइम्स लाइक पेप्सिनोजन एंड प्रोरेनिन फ्रॉम सम and some lipase is there. Oxyntic cells, they secrete HCl. This is a function of liver. Liver is your largest gland, around 1.5 kg weight. Color reddish brown. It is bilobed. Large right lobe and small left lobe. Each lobe is formed of structure and functional unit called hepatic lobules. This is a inner structure of the liver. So it secretes alkaline bile juice. So bile transport from liver to duodenum. First the bile stored goes via hepatic duct, then stored in gallbladder, from gallbladder to cystic duct, then common bile duct, then common hepatopancreatic duct, then finally duodenum, which is a part of small intestine. So this is a route how this bile transport from liver to duodenum. This is important. So the hepatopancreatic duct is guarded by sphincter of Oddi. That is a muscle. That is sphincter of Oddi. You can see in the yellow mark where it is there. Okay. You can see the pancreas also, it's a yellow color structure. So pancreatic duct or bile duct is common. That's why we call it as hepatopancreatic duct. It's open into the duodenum. So bile has no enzyme. Remember, bile has no enzyme, but contains a bile pigment, that is bilirubin and biliverdin, bile salt, cholesterol, and phospholipids. Pancreas is your second largest gland after liver. It's seen near duodenal loops. It is a cream color heterocrine gland. Heterocrine means they are also exocrine and endocrine. To be enzymes bhi produce karti hai, hormone bhi produce karti hai. The exocrine part has a pancreatic duct that opens into the duodenum along with the bile duct, and exocrine part secretes alkaline pancreatic juice. It contains inactive protease enzymes like trypsinogen, chymotrypsinogen, and procarboxypeptidase, amylase, lipase, and nucleases. And the other tubular glands, they are found in the intestine. They are the crypts of liver cums, that is consists of mucus secreting goblet cells and enzymes secreting Paneth cells. Duodenal cells confined to some mucosa of duodenum that secretes mucus only.